on the record. The time now is 53 minutes past 11 on this Thursday, February the 25th of the year Lord 2021. You are now in an open court under Title 28, Section 636 of Chapter Golf, and under Martial Law, Rule 203, Jurisdiction over the Offense. For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce, Federal Postal Judge, so I jurist presiding in this Superior Court of Record, is now going to file a claim under Star Paving, who is responsible for the damage to the private property of J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce. And we are going to make a phone call. It's on the record. The number we're calling is 87, area code 505. Area code 505, 877-0380. And we're calling. It's on the record now. Good morning. Who may I have the pleasure to be speaking with today, this morning?
This is Brenda. May I help you?
Yeah, Brenda. Is this Star Paving?
Yes.
Brenda. Okay, Brenda. Good morning. Good afternoon. No, good morning. 11:55. Well, 5 minutes sir, before noon.
You hold on?
No. No. Okay, now who may I have the pleasure to be speaking with this morning?
This is Brenda, sir. Can I help you?
Okay, yeah, I need to make a claim under your old risk liability insurance. For the Honorable Jesus Arriaga Abonce is making a claim under your liability insurance for property damage. It was reported to one of your workers here for the equipment malfunction. My Land Rover or a Land Rover got damaged. Did he turn that claim in?
Let me transfer you, sir, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You've reached Star Paving Safety Program. This is Daryl Bradley, the safety officer. Sorry, I'm to call. If you please leave your name and number and the purpose of the call, I'll definitely get back to you. Thank you. Bye.
Good morning. For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce, Federal Judge, Federal Postal Judge, Suai Juris, presiding in this Superior Court of Record, you were informed of an accident that occurred while you were paving on the corner of Maestas Drive and Camino del Rey. Equipment malfunction resulted on damage to the property for the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce, Federal Postal Judge, presiding in this Superior Court of Record. And please return my phone call. It's on the record. If you fail to return this phone call, it will be forensic evidence of malfeasance, nonfeasance, and misfeasance, and I will proceed accordingly, and you will fall into liquidated damages of $50,000 per day, 72 hours from this phone call. Failure to act up on a ministerial duty on the witnessing of a constitutional wrong is punishable, return the phone call. The area code 505-357-5421. Thank you. It's on the record. Okay, well, now your witness that for the Honorable has called Star Paving Company. They place an equipment here, barrels. They close the road. And their equipment malfunction resulted on the damage of the property. And we are going to take this opportunity to go and take a look at it. This guy, this one person that we just contact is going to be commanded to go and look at the video. If he doesn't proceed within 72 hours, his fall and liquidated damages at the tune of $50,000 per day on lawful money minted by the United States Treasury. And now we're going to take this apparatus or this video recorder, and we are going to walk in there. However, I will not turn this equipment to record while I am walking over there, because I don't want you to be disturbed by all these moving images. However, when I get there, I will turn it into a mode where it is going to essentiate all damage caused by the malfunction equipment, by the malfunction of the equipment that the Star Paving place on the street. And we're going to document another phenomenon here. For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce is a federal postal judge sui juris who has disabilities. Okay. The ramp, the handicap ramp that it was built to accommodate for the disabilities for the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce has been removed, and this is in violation of the 1964 Disabilities Act, or the Disabilities Act of 1964. Now, at this time, we are going to turn the equipment, and I apologize for any inconvenience while doing this. Oh, now, let's see, we're going to return this, and if I can return it here while I'm recording, it will be great. If not, I will have to turn the apparatus to show you a Land Rover on the street, and you can look at the damage. Okay. So you have a clear good image of what's going on. The equipment was placed about this far in this side of the street. And when the wind was blowing, we had a very, very gusted winds here a few days ago. The sign flew, hit the bumper, and fell into the street at this mark, this yellow mark. And now we are going to walk. We are walking over to where the handicap ramp was placed, built, and without any authority, without any consent. They came, Star Paving or the concrete company, whoever it was, came over to remove this handicap ramp, which you can see now. that the handicap ramp is gone, and now they replace it with a ramp that it does not meet the code for handicapped. That's the discrimination under the 1964 Disabilities Act. Now, in this same video, we are now going to step inside, and we're gonna make a phone call to the city of Los Lunas to see what's going on. And we're gonna start sorting all this out, because it's discrimination. This is discrimination. For the Honorable J. Jesús Arriaga Ponce has disabilities and built a ramp to accommodate for his disabilities. The city of Los Lunas in the county of Valencia, New Mexico, apparently contracted a company to come over, and without any consent, remove the handicap ramp. And by doing that, it is violation of the Disabilities Act. Now we're gonna go and continue in this video. But before that, we're gonna call to their attention that the property is protected by the Geneva Conventions of 1949 and Protocol 1 of 1977. Its property cannot be destroyed. So now we're going to place a phone call, and we're going to talk to the code officer. To see what's the story behind this, because they don't have any authority to come and remove your handicap ramp, leaving you now in discrimination to your disabilities and without any access. Now we're gonna go here and we're gonna talk to Village of Los Lunas. And then we're gonna talk to the city manager, Village of Los Lunas. And then we're gonna go and see what they say. So please stay with us. The number to dial. Village of Los Lunas, let's see. Village of Los Lunas. In their official site, then we're gonna go here. Mm-hmm. It's funny how they don't have their number right on. You have to go and look for it. It seems like they are. And then let's see if we have it here on our phone. And then why don't we talk to We apologize. This happens on real-time video. And this is forensic evidence that we are preserving to essentiate the phone call. See it here. There we go. Okay, now we're gonna go and get this on the county clerk, and then talk to the city manager. Okay, because we've been wanting to talk to him anyway. And this goes for Juan, Daniel, Paul, Monete, now we're going to go here, we got Village of Los Lunas, so we're going to call the Village of Los Lunas. Good afternoon, who I have the pleasure to be speaking with this morning?
Who is it that you're trying to speak to?
Well, I have to be polite. I always like to be asking who I have the pleasure to be speaking with, and then I will proceed to state who I want to speak with. May I have your full given name for the record, please?
My name is Dominique.
All right, Dominique. Thank you very much. Is that your full given name?
Yes, my name is Dominique.
Okay, thank you. May I please talk to Adolf?
1 moment, please.
Thank you. Adolf works at the code department, enforces code. We're going to find out why is it that he came over to violate the code by which our driveway or the ramp, the handicap ramp, was remove and replace with a non-handicap.
Adolf Lopez with the Village of Los Lunas Code Enforcement Division. If this is an emergency, please hang up. Call 911. If you're calling to report a code enforcement or animal control issue, you can now do this online through code enforcement service request at loslunasnm.gov or call 839-3842 to report by phone. For all other calls, please leave a detailed message and I will respond as soon as possible. Thank you.
Record your message at the tone. When you are finished, hang up or press pound for more options.
Good afternoon, Adolf. For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Avance, 1989 Maestas Drive. I need to file an insurance claim under your all-risk liability for damages to private property. This property I'm talking about is the Land Rover that was damaged by the malfunction of the equipment on this company that the village hired to repave the street. They also remove the handicap ramp and replace it with a non-handicap ramp. Is violation of the Disabilities Act of 1964. If you could be so kind to call this number, 505-357-5421, I certainly appreciate your help. But there is a code violation here on this on regard of discrimination of the Disabilities Act and the disabilities of an elderly who is protected by the Geneva IV Conventions of 1949 and Protocol 1 of 1977. Honorable member of the Military Welfare Service and the National American Red Cross, please take immediate action to correct this code violation. It is on the record and you are now sitting on the witness stand in this Superior Court of Record and in the United States Court, District Court, for the Corporate District of New Mexico, the Corporate United States District Court for the Corporate District of New Mexico. And the case number is 1:20-CharlieVictor 00113 Kilo Golf Uppercase Juliet Hotel Romeo. Where for the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga is presiding in this Superior Court of Record, you are hereby commanded and compelled to restore the accommodations for an elderly with disabilities by replacing the ramp to the normal ramp to accommodate for the disability. The disabilities for the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce, Federal Postal Judge, su I juris in this presiding in this Superior Court of Record. It's on the record. I will appreciate your help. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day. It's on the record. As you witness, you make a claim, you have to secure the record. And this record is hereby secure as of Thursday, February 25th, 14 minutes past noon. And we are going to continue with another video. And the minute he called, we'll record and we'll follow up. For the time being, now you have witnessed that this court has placed a claim, and that's forensic evidence. This is forensic evidence. Justice Johnson, Squire Johnson, Chief Justice for this for the corporate United States District Court, for the corporate districts of New Mexico. I adopt your oath, bind you to it, remind you of your fiduciary duty, and invite you to enforce the contract and administer the law in the witnessing of a constitutional wrong, or you will be compelled to the same constitutional wrong. And I have to tell you this three times. So that's one. For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce adopts the oath of Chief Squire Johnson in the Corporate United States District Court for the District of Corporate New Mexico. Adopt your oath, bind you to it, remind you of your fiduciary duty, extend sovereign immunity while you carry our orders under Title 28 on an open court under Title 28, Section 636, Subchapter Gulf, and under martial law, Rule 203, jurisdiction over the offense. That's number two, okay? For the Honorable J. Jesus Arriaga Abonce adopts and accepts the oath of Squire Johnson, Chief Justice for the Corporate United States District Court for the Corporate District of New Mexico. Adopt your oath, bind you to it, remind you of your fiduciary duty, and extend sovereign immunity while you carry the orders under Title 28, Open Court, Section 636, Title 28, U.S. Code, Section 636, Subchapter Gulf, and invite you, and invite Esquire Johnson, to perform under your oath and contract, and to enforce the law on a witnessing, to enforce the Constitution on a witnessing of a constitutional wrong. It is unconstitutional to remove a handicap ramp without consent of the handicap human being and replace it with a handicap that does not meet the requirements. We have forensic evidence on this video, and it's going to be submitted. It's submitted now. So you are compelled to perform and administer the law. Your solemn oath compels nothing less. From one Chief Justice Esquire Roberts, Esquire Johnson, in the Corporate United States District Court for the Corporate District of Corporate New Mexico. And we're going to pause this for now. It's on the record. To the contrary, your malfeasance, nonfeasance, and misfeasance will be forensic evidence of compounding to the same constitutional wrong. It is so ordered on this 25th day of February of the year 2021, 20 minutes past noon. That's the time. Thank you. Fix it now.